und Gesicht meistens heute.
Okay. How does it feel at the end of a day like that? Do you like your job in an evening like that?
I love my job, but I hate talking to people like you.
Thanks.
No, do you mean? I love it right now because I said earlier on, you're the last person I'm talking to, so you probably get the best interview, darling, don't worry.
I mean the whole thing like this afternoon when you have to talk to so many journalists, what goes
inside? Well, it's part of my job, so I have to do it. We don't do it that often, so I mean it's like, this is the first kind of press conference we've had for a long while, you know, 3, 4, 5 years maybe. So I don't mind it. If I had to do this every day, forget it.
Do you sometimes have the feeling that, I mean, obviously people are asking the same questions all the time, that it's
the
music is your statement and not the talking?
No, I think it's more than music, you know, we're personalities, so you talk about more than music. I mean, if all you talked about was music, depending on if you're a music paper, then you talk about music. But there's more to us than just writing songs. I mean, we do other things and we have characters and depends what you talk about. So I don't mind it. No. And of course people ask the same questions because some of the questions are current and they want to know about the same things. So ask me about my solo album then, huh?
Yeah, what about your solo album?
Oh, it's great.
Of course it is. Does it sound very different?
Yes, it sounds...
I heard you had a break.
Hopefully it's not finished yet, see, so I don't know how it's going to come out. But at the moment I've worked on it for about two or three months, and I was supposed to finish it before the Queen tour, but I needed a bit more time. And it's sounding good. It's nice to actually play with different people, because I've always played with Queen all the time, and so I had a drummer from, the session drummer from Munich, and a guitarist from Munich, so basically all German players, and it's made my song sound different, you know.
To people outside, it sometimes feels funny that or special that there are so many solo projects, whereas the band is still going as well on the side. How would you analyze the influence of the solo stuff for the band when you come back together again? Is that an advantage that you're four strong writers who also do stuff on your own, or does it?
Yes, I think. In a funny way, I thought because I think this is one of the few groups that all four members write, and I thought that we'd be doing solo albums much before this. But I think, in a funny way, when we do a Queen album, they are like four solo projects within themselves anyway, because I mean, I have my bunch of songs, Brian has his, and Roger and John, and so it's like four little solo projects working side by side, and then we put them all together. So I think that was the reason that we didn't actually go and do solo projects earlier on. I mean, if we were writing all the same kind of songs, then we would have gotten fed up and said, oh, I want to do my solo album first. But we're all writing different songs, so it keeps us interested. So for, about 13 years or whatever, you know, that was interesting enough for us to carry on. And as far as I was concerned, all Queen albums were little solo projects anyway. I was writing my kind of songs that I wanted. But now I think the time has come where I want a whole album of my own, and Roger's done two already, so I think most people thought that I would be the first one to have a solo album, and then the band, Queen would break up and all that, but here you are, after 13 years, four old ladies are still rocking away.
What about the actual work in the studio when you four come together and everybody wants to bring his side of songs?
Yeah, that happens all the time, yeah.
It sounds like having also...
It's like a cockfight, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, four cocks fighting. God, it's getting nice, this. No, but you know, the funny thing is, this sort of happened almost when we met, the four of us, and it's just... You won't believe it. I mean, people think that, okay, now they're fighting. We fought on virtually the first day, because we used to know each other from university and all that, and we used to fight about musical ideas and this and that, because we're all very strong characters, you know, and we all have egos and all that, so we always kept fighting. But I think the fighting seems to keep us together, because I think sometimes... I think bands break up when there's one very strong person and the others, and the others get left out, and they think, oh, God, this... asshole is just too strong and we want to join another band. But the four of us are real... Actually, I can't say these four-letter words. Huh? we're very strong, you know, individually, so we just keep going at each other. And I think the reason we've stayed together for so long is just none of us want to leave, because, I mean, if you leave, it's like being a coward and you're going out. So we still keep going. And as long as the music is still there, and as long as the people are still buying the music, then it's okay. When they stop buying our records, then I'll say goodbye and do something else, become a strip artist or something.
Yeah. What music you would strip? What music would you use?
All the songs I've written. Like, come on.
Announcing a tour like that, if you think of the tour life that's ahead of you, is that a pleasant imagination, or do you hate tour life, basically?
What, touring?
Touring and all this.
It depends. I mean, this tour I'm looking forward to, because we haven't done it for 2 years. There was a time where we were doing tours so extensively, because, I mean, we would go into a studio, make an album, and then tour the world, and then we'd go back, and that was the routine. I mean, I didn't have any time to actually break away. And we virtually did that for about 8 or 9 years. And that's why the last couple of years we wanted to break away from that format, because I was getting very bored, and so were the others, and just to get away and do different things and think about certain things. And so this tour I'm looking forward to, because we haven't toured, and we can do different things. It's going to be it's going to be fresh, you know. And otherwise, there were tours I hated, because, I mean, we used to do American tours that lasted for 3 or 4 months, and towards the end, it was just terrible. I just never wanted to go on a stage again, because after a while, the songs sounded very, you know, if you're doing it for 3 months, you have to say, do the same routine, and, you know, you need time away so you can get freshness into it. And I think that probably happens to everybody.
What's the fresh element now in the new tour that you're
doing? My costume. No, it's just, it's new. I mean, the one thing, element that I like on this tour is that we are actually going to go all the way back and do songs from all the old albums as well, because so that I think anybody coming to see Queen this time is going to get a little piece of all the albums. So, I mean, there are times where somebody comes to a show and say, oh, they didn't do anything from this album or whatever. Of course, we can't do all the songs from 13 albums, it would be there for 2 days. But I think what we're doing is we're going to take, even if it's one song from one album or two from each, we're not going to leave any album out. So I think that that to me is fun, because we've been practicing some of the early stuff. I mean, we're practicing Keep Yourself Alive and Liars from the first album. And it made me think, you know, that about 13 years ago we were doing this, and at that time I had long hair and black fingernails and makeup and everything, the kind of thing that Boy George is doing right now. And to think that I'd sort of still be singing those songs, it sort of makes me sound old, doesn't it?
Well,
I don't look too bad for 37, I tell you.
Do you have the feeling that a lot of people are imitating, because you mentioned Boy George, do you have the feeling that you see them come and go while your career is going on, you know, so many new bands?
I don't think Boy George is going to come and go. I think Boy George is going to be here for a long while. They always have, I mean, there's always people that come up like that, and for me, you can always tell somebody who's going to stay, and Boy George is going to stay. Mm-hmm. I don't know. What do you think?
Yes, I think so too. The question is, what will he wear in 10 years?
Oh, that doesn't matter. I mean, you know, that's the least of his problems, I should think, you know.
What does it mean to you? I mean, I talked to Keith Richards recently, and he said the most important thing in his career was when he realized that being on stage and being admired by young kids is not the answer to life. Did you have a similar experience once, when you first of all thought that's it, and then you, from a certain stage, you're thinking of something else?
No, the most important thing to me is to be happy, to be honest, to have fun. And depending on whatever I do, I mean, of course, music is important to me, and because that's my life. And as long as, I mean, I can, I'll carry on as long as I write music and people want to buy it. That's important to me, but I mean, that's not the be-all and the end-all. I mean, I just, they're very, to me, happiness is the most important thing. And if I'm happy, then it shows in my work. And so basically, I just want to be happy and make a lot of money and buy a lot of things, especially in Vienna.
Yeah, antique. Yep, just a moment.
Thank you.
You were also recording something with Michael Jackson that was not released yet. I think the song is even called Victory. Is that true?
That's right. Yeah. I've done like three tracks with him, and that's about a year ago, longer than that. And yes, Victory was one of the songs, but he wanted to use the title for the Jackson thing. But the song is still there, and it's probably just waiting until the two of us get together and finish it.
You haven't finished it yet?
No, I mean, it's just because he has commitments, I have commitments, and it's very difficult. I mean, he's on tour, I'm going on tour, and you've got to sort of, you know, it's very, very difficult when two different, you know, musicians are trying to get together. I mean, he has to do his stuff, and it's just that when I was spending some time in L.A. and we're friends, he said, oh, why don't we try something? So, I mean, one day it'll probably be finished, and... Well, the other song is called State of Shock, which I did, and Mick Jagger's on it, but it's all okay, because Michael called me up and said, look, I want to finish a song, I want it on the Jackson's album, and I said, I can't come over, because I'm in Munich, and he said, well, is it okay if Mick does it? So I said, fine, you know, songs are songs, I mean, as long as our friendship carries on, we can write all kinds of songs after that.
With what other people could you think of cooperating, like you do with Bowie and Jackson on this unreleased stuff? What are people who are interested?
It depends. I mean, I just I don't sort of think of those things. I mean, sometimes you just meet friends, and if you think about doing a song together, you talk about that. Otherwise, that's not what I think about all the time. I mean, Elton and I have been friends for a long time, but we've actually sort of said to each other, one day we probably go in there together and write a song. But it's better being friends, you know what I mean? Mm. And the thing about it is it's spontaneity. So I mean, it's just if it happens that we're talking and suddenly we say, oh, let's go in the studio and do it. That's the best thing. And that's what happened with David Bowie. He was just around. We were having dinner for a couple of days, and we were recording in a studio, and he just said, oh, maybe I'll come in and just see what happens. So it wasn't planned. If it's planned, then it's boring, because then it just... And we were just going in there and fooling around to see what happened, and suddenly this song started taking shape, and we said, oh, that's quite nice, let's work on it a bit. And the result of that was Under Pressure. So I'm not really... I don't get up every morning and say, okay, who am I going to work with today? Those kind of things don't work.
How would you describe yourself as an artist? Would you say that you're a very organized person, very spontaneous person, or how would you say?
No, myself as an artist, I'm just a musical prostitute, my dear. Just basically that.
Organized or not?
Oh, who cares? Disorganized and organized. That's an asshole question to ask anybody. It's just, I don't know, I'm just me, you know, I'm just me. I'm very disorganized at times, I'm organized at times, and I'm just me.
What emotions do you have when you see old stuff, for example, like you mentioned before, with long hair and black fingers?
Oh, when I see myself?
When I see yourself.
Oh dear, I want to tear them all up. I just think, I actually laugh at myself. But I know that it was something that you have to do. I think someone like Boy George, in about 5 or 10 years' time, is going to look and say, oh my God, did I really look like that? But he knows that it was relevant at the time, and it was right. And I think I don't regret any of the things I did. It's just that I laugh. I mean, what did you look like 10 years ago?
Horrible. Yeah.
Do you look at your pictures? And
yes.
Oh, there you are then. Yeah. So I mean, I just think, and it's a process of growing up. You know, it's experience. And I just think at this point in time, I think if I had long hair and fingernails and wearing the things, I would look ridiculous. I mean, I looked ridiculous then, but it worked. But it was all right then. So it's just growing up and gaining experience.
If you look at all members of the band, I know it's a difficult question, but what do you think every single member does contribute to the special chemistry that's Queen in the end?
It's hard to sort of pinpoint those things, because I mean, we certainly have an ingredient between the four of us, otherwise it wouldn't have worked. especially for this long. And we all have a role to play, but I couldn't tell you what it was. I mean, it's just, the only thing I could tell you is that is the reason is because we are diverse. We're four different characters coming from, and that's why I think it's worked. Not two of us are the same. I mean, so that, you know, we all like totally different things, but we come together, and it's a chemistry that works. And I couldn't tell you what it was, because, I mean, who can? It's just something that seems to fit. And that's what good bands are made of, you know? And we're good.
Okay, thank you very much.
That's the line, the end. That was perfect.